Those of you that are familiar with using Portage are probably aware that one of the nice quality of life features that it has is its color-coded output. As you can see here, the output of this emerge-p command is nicely color-coded, makes it easy to tell what is and isn't important, and it makes it easy to categorize the information that you're viewing here on the screen. But what happens if you want to make modifications to the actual color output of Portage, but you don't really want to touch your other color settings, such as inside your terminal emulator's configuration? Well, the best way to go about doing that is actually to use a file called color.map to map colors yourself to customize your Portage output. Now, color.map, just like all of your other Portage configuration files, is going to go in the etc Portage directory. As you can see here, I already have the color.map file created, but it is likely not created by default in your Portage installation. Now, before we get into actually editing color.map, we can get some information about it by running man5 color.map, which will give Portage's built-in information regarding this file. Now, right away, you might see that it seems to have a very simple syntax of just a variable followed by, it says here, a space delimited list of attributes. And then down here in this list, you can see the variables, normal, bad, bracket, and the associated colors. Now, this might actually give you a bit of a misleading impression of color.map, because if you were to go into the color.map file and try to say, in all caps, normal equals and then something else, like a different color, like red or something, that would actually have no effect. That's because in the color.map file, you're not actually mapping these variables to colors. Instead, you're mapping already existing colors to other colors. If you scroll down in the documentation here, you will see that they have a section under the variables called the valid attributes. And these are going to have foreground and background colors, as well as some additional attributes such as bold and other such modifications that can be added to text. When you're actually using the color.map file, you don't want to try to set those variables near the top of the file to a different color. You want to map one of the colors or the background colors or the attributes here to another color or background color or attribute. Now, once you know that color.map is for mapping colors to other colors, actually working with the file is very, very easy. Now, to do a quick demonstration, I'm going to emerge-p for pretend Audacity here, so that we can get a good example of the output that Emerge usually produces. Alright, so we've seen how that looks now. We've seen that this name here for the actual package that I'm emerging is green, and all the use flags that I'm using are red, and the ones that are not being used are blue. So let's make a change to color.map so that we can see some output modifications here. Sudo vim color.map. Let's change red to yellow. Now, if you'll recall from the man page, the syntax is very simple. It's attribute equals space delimited list of other attributes. So a valid line here in color.map would be red equals yellow. Now, what that should do is every time Portage would normally use the color red, it will instead use the color yellow. And we can check and see if that works by writing the changes here. And then once again, emerging Audacity. And as you can see, it did work. All the times that red was going to be used up here in the use flags and down here in the CPU flags, they are all now yellow instead. So we've used color.map to translate, to map one color to another color, at least in the context of when Portage intends to use those colors. Now, if you recall from the man page, there were other attributes that were listed besides just regular colors. For instance, there were background colors and the other attributes text modifications that you could make. So as you can see, I have here another basic output of the emerge audacity command. I've removed the change that we made previously, so it's back to looking like it's going to look by default. So let's go ahead and make another change to color.map, and this time let's give it a background color as well as a bold attribute so that we can see how that looks. And this time let's do that to the green here. Let's make the green a different color like red. So we want to do sudo vim color.map. And here we'll want to say green equals, and then a space delimited list of attributes. So let's say we want it to be the color red, and we want it to have a different background color too. So this time let's say BG light gray to give it a light gray background, which should stand out a lot against the black background that my terminal has. And let's also make it bold. All right, now that we've got that space delimited list here, let's write our changes. And let's once again run emerge-p audacity. And you can see all the changes that we made took effect. Where it was previously green, it is now red with a light gray background. It's not so easy to see the bold. The bold is not so visible because that text is actually bolded by default as well because of its color class. But using this, you can see the color.map gives you a lot of control over actually how you can have Portage display all this information. The stuff that you want to be important can obviously be made important. Look how well this stands out against the black background here. If there's some specific class that you want to change and make display this way, it's easily done. You can easily highlight the information that's critically important to you, or you can use it if you have unusual colors that you use for your background, for instance. This could be a great way to help make your Portage output stand out against those backgrounds. Now, before I go, one last thing I want to talk about is what the variable section in the color.map man page is actually for. I mentioned near the beginning of the video that the variables are not what you actually set in the color.map file. Instead, there are a guide here that is supposed to tell you what certain colors are supposed to represent in the output of Portage. You can see that normal output is supposed to be set to normal. So if you change the way that normal is in your color.map file, then it's going to affect what Portage considers to be normal output, which is to say it's going to affect the color used for some words occurring in other contexts than the ones below. Bad is supposed to be red, so if you change red, it's going to change what bad output, according to Portage, is going to look like. And you can go through this list of variables here to find out what all the colors represent. Several colors are used more than once, like red is used both for bad and down here for package blockers, and for a few other things as well. But these variables here are supposed to be a guide to inform you how certain things are set in the color.map file. That is, what the colors are supposed to represent, so you can have an idea of what it means when you change them. All right, that about does it. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully this gave you some insight into how to customize the output of your Portage commands. I wanted to make this video because there wasn't a lot of like step-by-step instruction on how to use the color.map file, and I floundered with it for a while thinking you were supposed to set the variables instead of map colors to other colors. So hopefully if anybody else is having issues with something like that, this video will be helpful to you. But thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.